myself, Professor Tushar Gujarati from S&T College of Engineering, Yewla. Now we'll study actuators. So in these actuators, we are going to study the servo motor, stepper motor and solenoids. So what is actuator? Actuator is nothing but the device which gives motion to particular device. Okay, the motion can be given either circular or linear. That is called as actuator, which actuates something. Okay, that is called as actuator. So there are types are there: servo motor, stepper motor, solenoid valves, and hydraulics and pneumatics. So these are some type of actuators. So what is stepper motor? So it is discrete positioning device. So we get discrete positions, like step by step we get positions. So it is called as discrete positions. So it moves one step at a time for each input. Okay. Appropriate excitation in winding makes the rotor attract towards the stator. So we have to excite the windings. So windings are used, and we have to excite the appropriate windings so that it makes the rotor attract towards the stator. So this is the diagram of stepper motor. So this is permanent magnet stepper motor. So here this is permanent magnet stepper motor. So here coils are used, signal A and signal B. So here this is signal A, okay, passing through this coil. Okay, this is signal A coil, and one more coil is there, signal B. So here it is signal B. So this is signal B. Okay, so like this there are two signals, signal A and signal B. So here we are using permanent magnet disc with two poles. So this is permanent magnet disc with two poles having S and N pole. Okay. And there is rotor shaft coming out of the page. So this is rotor shaft between S and N pole. It is shaft. Okay. So what happens? We have to actuate these signals one by one. Signal A and signal B we have to actuate. So as we actuate signal B or signal A, the rotor tries to move towards that signal. Okay. Suppose we have actuated signal B like this. So rotor tries to maintain the minimum reluctance position in this direction. Okay. And it tries to rotate by that direction. And when we give signal to signal A, at that time it tries to come to this horizontal position. Okay. When signal is given to signal B, then it is vertical position, and when it is given to A, then it will take horizontal position. Like this stepper motor works. So this is also one type of diagram. Same diagram is shown here. So stepper motor, so suppose this is signal A and this is B. So when we actuate the pair of A, at the time this rotor moves, takes horizontal position. It takes horizontal position, and when we give signal to this B, at the time this rotor takes vertical position. Okay, so like this we have to give sequential input properly. So like this you can use number of stators, or you can take more number of windings. So here in first diagram, three pairs are taken, winding three pairs, and in second diagram almost six pairs of rotor windings are taken. Okay, so that we get small number of steps. For getting small number of steps, we need higher number of coils, and we have to actuate these coils step by step. Okay. So for multi steps we need higher number of pairs. Now we'll study solenoids. So it is electromagnetic actuator. Solenoid means what? It is electromagnetic actuator. It has movable ferrite core. So solenoid has movable ferrite core. Ferrite core is actuated by current flow. So this ferrite core is actuated by current flow. So steps. energizing coil, then establishing magnetic field, then pushing or pulling the core. Okay, these are the steps. So now you check here, in the center position you can see that the core is moving around this coil. So as these coils are activated one by one, this core gets attracted toward these coils. Okay, so like this coils moves, sorry, so like this the core moves through these coils because it gets attracted towards the particular coil. Okay, this is solenoids. It is useful for linear movement. It is also called as electromagnetic actuator. Now we'll study servo motor. So it is special kind of motors which rotate for certain angle for given electrical signal. So these are special kind of motors. Simple DC motor controller with servo mechanism. So here controller is used in servo motors. So we are using here controller, that is DC motor controller with servo mechanism. It provides angular precision. Suppose if we set for 20 degree angle, then it will give us exactly 20 degree angle. So we get angular precision over here. It has error sensing feedback to correct the performance. So we have here error sensing feedback also. Its application in toy car you can use, in CD player you can use this servo motor. Okay. So this is the diagram of servo motor. So here this is the motor. This motor is connected to some load. So load is applied on this motor. So here we are using comparator. Okay. Comparator compares two signal. So one signal is input signal. So this is control signal. And second signal is position sensor. So position sensor gives signal of position, and this position is compared with this control signal, and accordingly errors is generated. And this error is given to motor. Okay, so like this servo motor works. So what happens here in servo motor? The controller is provided. Controller or comparator. Comparator compares two signals. One is position sensor signal and one is control signal. And according to error, it operates the motor. Okay, so like this servo motor operates. Okay, so up to this point, is it clear? So thank you so much all of you for watching this video. We have studied servo motor, stepper motor and solenoids. In the next video we will try to understand hydraulic and pneumatics. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video.